Welcome back to the channel, another day. We are building Jessica a nightstand to match the rest of her bedroom suit. So far, I've already built her a bed, a dresser, and a blanket stand. This nightstand will probably be it for her bedroom. At least that's what I think anyway. So we picked up all of our lumber and wood products from Home Depot. They were nice enough to cut a lot of these larger pieces down to size for us. However, they were off the mark just a little bit. So it took a little time, but we had to go back and fine tune a lot of these pieces to make sure they were at the right sizes that we had planned on them to be. Any other day, this really wouldn't be a problem. But man, it was cold that day. I mean, it was cold. I had like 70 degree weather that whole week, and then all of a sudden we had rain, 30 degree weather. Last thing I wanted to do was stand in the garage with the door open, cutting all these pieces to size. Using a 2x6, ribbing it down to 2x2s, I used these as the legs for the nightstand. Now cutting the top down to size. Here we're going to measure and cut the 2x2 legs for the nightstand. When you're measuring these and making your cuts, keep in mind how much lumber is right now. Do yourself a favor, measure twice and cut once. On the video camera, I have my main man, Zach, holding it steady for me, as you can see. We're going to use some 3/4 inch pocket holes on the sides of this plywood, which will be our sides for the nightstand. All the materials used on this project can be found in the description box below. Just under subscribe. When doing this, do yourself a favor and make sure you measure where you want your pocket hole screws to go to in reference to where you want your shelves on the nightstand that you're building. Otherwise, you'll end up with a problem like we have here, where our pocket holes are not exactly lining up with where our shelves needed to be. A mistake that I have made before, and I have failed to learn my lesson. Don't be like me. Using leftover 2x2s, we use these on the front and back for support pieces, but also to line up flush with the shelves, making it a nice, clean, even finish all the way around. Sorry, the battery ran dead on the camera. So this is what we did for the top. So we put the top on, it's just a paneling piece here. This is what we did, since you really can't get to anything for pocket holes or nothing. We countersunk some holes here, and we put 1.5 inch pocket hole screws in here on both sides. Right there and right there, I didn't countersink that one too well. But a lot of wood glue countersunk those screws in. So now we'll just let it sit there and let the glue dry for a little while, and then we'll get to work on the door.
Door frame, I took a 1x6 and ribbed it down to 1x2 boards, and adding pocket holes on the ends to screw them and glue them together. Make sure everything stays in place. I advise using these large clamps like I have here. Attaching a 1/4 inch hardwood plywood to the back of this door frame. We're gonna glue it and nail it. I'm going to install the door. Using a deck of cards and some paint sticks, I line it up on all four sides to make sure it's nice and even, so that opening and closing operation of the door is easy. Getting the hinges lined up where they need to be and marking where my holes are going to be. From here, we'll go ahead and install my hinges. Had to go to the store. I did not have enough stain, there we go, to finish the door and the nightstand itself. So we're using this Mini Wax brand. It's a wood finish. We enjoy this brand. That color is what we've used for all of Jessica's furniture in her room, and they don't make it anymore. It's called a Summer Oak, and they can't pull up the numbers So I've got the guy who was very sweet at Lowe's to go ahead and he wasted a few cans of these, but he got what we needed. It's pretty close. All in all, ended up using two coats to do the whole thing. I think it turned out pretty nice though. And we also come back with some clear sealer and done one good coat on the whole nightstand. Now that everything's good and dry, ready to go, go ahead and install the hinges to the door. Then we had to make a trip back to the store to find a handle in which that my lovely daughter would be happy with. But on the back of the nightstand, we used a 1/4 inch piece of plywood, glued and nailed. Our finished product, the nightstand to complete Jessica's bedroom suite. Thanks for watching. Give us a like and subscribe.